Hello students, welcome to Learner's Planet. Problem session 4 of acids, bases and salts. In our previous session, we discussed questions about the indicators about pH. Right? This was the last question we discussed in our previous session. Now we will be discussing few more questions in this session. The first question of our session is, which acid is present in fatigued muscles? What do you mean by fatigued muscles? Fatigued muscles means tired muscles. You must have observed, children, when you play or when you run for long distance, what happens that you feel cramp in your legs, right? Now what type of acid is formed there? So when you are doing vigorous exercises, what happens? The oxygen supply to the muscles reduces. Okay? But still, while working out, you need energy. Okay? So for providing energy, what happens that your glucose, which is present in the muscle tissues, gets converted to pyruvate, right, by the process called as glycolysis. Okay, this is an anaerobic process. Now there are two pathways for pyruvate. One is, if sufficient oxygen is present, this pyruvate gets oxidized to carbon dioxide and water, giving lots of energy. Right, children? Sorry. But if when you are working out for a long time, what happens, students? The oxygen supply to the tissues reduces. So what will happen here? Your pyruvate, what happens to pyruvate is, pyruvate is converted to lactic acid. Right? Now this is an anaerobic process, that is, this doesn't require oxygen. So this gives energy. Now children, the lactic acid which is formed gets deposited in the fatigued muscles. So what will be the answer of our question? Which acid is present in fatigued muscles? Our answer is lactic acid. Clear? So the pyruvate to lactic acid, this is an anaerobic process. Okay, then let's take up our next question, that is, which acid and base is used to prepare NaHCO3 and NaHSO3? Its formula should be NaHSO3, it should not be NaHSO4, it can be NaHSO4 also, right? So NaHSO4. Now here, students, if I take up NaHCO3, what is the base here? Na is there, so the base would be NaOH, right? And what would be the acid here? Carbon dioxide is present here. So what type of acid carbon dioxide is present? H2CO3, that is carbonic acid. This is what? Carbonic acid. Clear? Now in this case, I think you can also make it out. Na is there, so what would be the base? NaOH. HSO4, sodium bisulfate. So what would be the acid here, children? H2SO4. Right? So the acid and the base present in sodium bicarbonate is NaOH and carbonic acid, and the acid and the base present in sodium bisulfate is sulfuric acid and sodium hydroxide. So you can make out by seeing the structure or formula of the compound of what all acid and base it is made up of if it is a salt, right? Now moving to our next question. Yeah, it reads like, what are the products formed in a given reaction? Sodium bicarbonate with hydrochloric acid. Now in my theory session I told you that acids react with metal carbonates or bicarbonates evolving what? Carbon dioxide. And forming salt. Now in this case children, let's write the equation, that is NaHCO3 reacts with hydrochloric acid and it forms. Let's write the first product. What is the first product here? Let's write CO2 first, because we are sure of that CO2 is evolved. Then we are also, there is hydrogen, this is also hydrogen. So what else would be formed is water. What else would be formed here is a salt. So what all entities will react to form salt? Sodium and chlorine. So which salt would be present here children? It would be formed here, NaCl, right? So whenever a bicarbonate or a carbonate reacts with the acid, what is evolved is carbon dioxide gas, water is formed and also the salt. If I take another example here, that is calcium carbonate CaCO3. If it reacts with sulfuric acid H2SO4, right? And what it will be forming? What it will be forming, children? It would be CaSO4 plus H2O plus CO2, right? So now let's take up our another question, that is, how is the concentration of hydronium ion affected when a solution of acid is diluted? Now what do you mean by this? Concentration of hydronium ion, that is concentration of H3O plus ion. How is this H3O plus ion formed? That is H plus ion reacts with H2O forming what? H3O plus ion. Right? Now I have got acid in this container suppose, or I have got acid here, right? So what I am taking here is acid. If I am adding water to it, what will happen? The amount of H plus ion or concentration of H plus ion will decrease. That is H plus ion, that is the number of moles of H plus per ml. What will happen to this concentration? It would decrease. So what will happen to the concentration of H plus? It is decreasing. And what will happen to the pH? pH will be increasing, right? So So I can write it here that pH is increasing and the concentration of hydronium ion is decreasing. Clear? Now let's take up another question, that is, there is assertion. This question is of the pattern of your IITs or Olympiads. There you have got your assertion and reasoning type of question. So there is an assertion that washing soda crystals become moist when left in air. Is it right or wrong? When washing soda crystals are kept in moisture or in air, they get wet. So here what is the thing? Assertion is correct. Right? I can write it here that assertion is correct. Now let's see the reason of it. Washing soda reacts with moisture forming sodium hydroxide. So, is it the thing? No. Washing soda, will it react with moisture? No. Washing soda is a deliquescent solid, I told you. It takes up large amount of moisture from air, right? And so it is becoming wet or moist. Clear? Your washing soda takes up large amount of moisture from the air and it becomes wet. Right? So what is your reason? Your reason is wrong. So if you have got this assertion reasoning type question, you have to solve like this. You have to analyze the assertion first. Then you have to analyze whether the reason is correct explanation for assertion. If it's not, it is wrong. Clear? Now let's take up the next question. Right. The question is, what are the products formed when concentrated and dilute nitric acid react with lead? Now here, children, if I write the equation for the first question, I would like to tell you that concentrated nitric acid or dilute nitric acid is an oxidizing agent. So we can say that nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent. Right? Now what it does is, it oxidizes hydrogen evolved due to the reaction between what? Due to the reaction between the metal and acid. Right? And forms what? Water. And HNO3 is reduced to NO or NO2. Okay? So what will be the products formed here? Lead plus dilute nitric acid. What it will give, children? It will give PbNO3 whole twice plus, because it is dilute, it will be NO and H2O, nitrogen monoxide. And lead with concentrated nitric acid, concentrated HNO3, will give you what? Lead nitrate. PbNO3 whole twice plus of NO2 plus of H2O. Clear? So children, reaction with nitric acids proceeds like this. The salt is formed plus NO or NO2 depending on the concentration of acid. NO2 will be formed with concentrated acid and NO will be formed with dilute acid. Am I clear? And the hydrogen evolved is oxidized. It is only with very dilute nitric acid hydrogen is evolved. That's it. Okay, rest of the case the reaction proceeds like this. If there is copper in place of lead, it will form copper nitrate, nitrogen monoxide and water. If there is iron in place of lead, it will form ferric nitrate, nitrogen monoxide and water. Clear? Now let's take up our next question. Why anhydrous ammonium chloride fumes in moist air? So anhydrous ammonium chloride, ammonium chloride, what is the formula? It is aluminium chloride, I suppose. Yes, it is anhydrous. Why anhydrous aluminium chloride fumes in moist air? So aluminium chloride, what is the formula? It is AlCl3. Now when it is exposed to air, or I can write it here moist air, not necessarily moist air, it fumes in simple air also, because a small amount of moisture is also present. Okay, so moist air, it fumes. Now what are these fumes of? This AlCl3 reacts with water of atmosphere and it forms, what it will form? Aluminium hydroxide and HCl. So because of the formation of this HCl, anhydrous aluminium chloride fumes. Okay? So anhydrous aluminium chloride fumes in moist air due to the formation of HCl. Right, children? Now let's take up our next question. Yeah, it is, a blue salt becomes white on heating. Name the salt. Do you know what salt is this? Blue salt. The blue salt is copper sulfate. CuSO4 5H2O. Right? This is copper sulfate. Now what your question is saying, it is becoming white on heating. So this, you know why this copper sulfate has got blue color? Because of the presence of these water molecules. Now when you are heating, what will happen to these water molecules? The CuSO4 5H2O, when we are heating this, so what will happen? These water molecules will be removed off and we will get anhydrous CuSO4. Clear, students? So a blue salt, what is our answer? A blue salt becomes white on heating because, on heating, name the salt, it is copper sulfate, right? And it is, when it is heated, it is giving anhydrous copper sulfate. So this is what? This is hydrated copper sulfate. Am I clear? So likewise, the colors of hydrated salts are different. Like your FeSO4 7H2O is green in color. On heating it will become colorless. This is also called as green vitriol. Copper sulfate is called as blue vitriol. Right? Remember, this CuSO4 5H2O is also called as blue vitriol. Right? Your ZnSO4 7H2O is called as white vitriol. That means it is colorless. Okay? So, for this session, I'll conclude now. So, we have discussed the questions related to the properties of acids, the properties of bases, the salts, and also related to pH. And you practice as many questions you are getting, and I would suggest you that also solve NCERT questions. Okay?